Has anybody figured out technology yet? I have, but it's a little scary because actually what's going on with technology is, and before I tell you this, it's important to realize that you have an option other than technology. Otherwise, it's going to be too frightening and intimidating. And we do have an option, and I'll tell you about that just after I tell you the first part here. Technology is really all about distracting you from what it doesn't offer. It's all about distracting you from what it doesn't offer, okay? That's what it is, because it's not offering what we really want. So it's a massive marketing campaign to distract us away from this fact, to distract us away from the fact. And say, look, you've got, you know, 10 billion apps. What are you talking about? We're not offering you a lot of stuff. Yeah, but you're not offering me what I really want, which is the resolution of the continuity problem. That's all any of us actually really want. So, what is the resolution of the continuity problem? Now, let's go into this with a little greater effort here, more profound. I've said in a previous video that we have our inner being seems to be asleep because we asked it, go to sleep, I want you to go to sleep. And the fact is that the situation we're in here, struggles we have, are not the fault of spirit. We have to give spirit, our inner being, the benefit of the doubt. We asked it to go to sleep. Why? Because we were entranced, we were intrigued by all this technology. We say, well, I don't want to miss this. I'm part of something really cool. This is like advancement. This is historic. I want to be part of it. So they said, inner being, go to sleep, go to sleep. Don't bother me. Why? Because inner being would present to you the resolution of the continuity problem, which is infinitely more desirable than any technology, anything technology could ever give you. And so, because you want to kind of see what technology is like, this is kind of interesting, let me check this out. You say, hey, inner being, go to sleep, don't bother me this lifetime, don't bother me. Now, recently, I told my inner being to wake up. Instantly woke up, and I realized it was never asleep in the first place. It just had its eyes closed because I told it to go to sleep, and it can't sleep, so it closes its eyes and pretends to be asleep. And then it did something very interesting. It went into the backyard and started pulling apart this bale of hay and spreading it all around. And I said, what is it doing? And just today I realized what it's doing. Because the straw actually symbolizes the way the sun hits it glitters like light, it glistens like light. It was spreading it, it was showing me that it can give this vision of tinges of light to everything, which is the beginning, the awakening of the resolution of the continuity problem. Our inner being can do that for us. And it hasn't done it because we've been telling it to be asleep. But that's what it will do for us. And when we start to see light around everything, no, it's not a mental disease or illness at all. It's the inner being showing us this vision, which begins the resolution of the continuity problem as we see everything extending beyond its concrete reified appearance, okay, into infinity. Light extends. This is what our inner being can do for us. So let's give the inner being the benefit of the doubt that the reason why we're still so messed up and stuck is not its fault. We told it to go to sleep because it said, you know what, these smartphones are going to be coming out. Like, you know, it'd be able to, like, wow, take a picture and send it to somebody over another side of the world. Oh my gosh, isn't that cool? Well, you know, all this technology, you know, has been around long enough for us to realize it's really not that cool, right? It really isn't. I mean, it's actually gets pretty stale in a hurry, you know. And so it's not worth it. It's not worth it to tell your inner being to stay asleep. It's not worth it for you to go through your entire life never seeing light around everything, and then the subtle extension of everything to infinity, so you can realize and start feeling that spaciousness is infinite, and is able to contain all of spirit's adventures and ideas. It's not worth it. It's not worth it, like to text somebody. They say, wow, this is so incredible. I can say, hey, how you doing? Someone else say, hey, I'm fine, how you doing? Or like, hey, I take a picture. Wow, I'm shopping. Here's a picture. I sent it to my friends, Facebook or something. It's like, oh my God, you're shopping. I'm shopping too. Oh my God. This is incredible, right? I mean, how long does it take us to something to say, hey, wait a minute, are we being played here? Are we being played? You know? I mean, oh yeah, a new camera, new smartphone. You know, look what it does with video pictures. It stitches pictures together. You have a panorama. Oh my gosh, you know, this is incredible. How long does it take us to say, wait a minute, we're being played. We are being played here. Now, I was tipped off about this before it all got started, really. I was aware of it, but I still said, well, let me check this out, let me check it out, let me check it out. But I've checked it out now. And we're being played. We're being played by technology, all right? We are being played. It's everything but what we really want, all right? It's just a massive distraction away from what we really want. So how about us recognizing this and accepting it and not blaming Spirit and says, you know, Spirit, the whole problem is I'm telling you to stay asleep, where I could actually say, hey, you know, wake up, Spirit. I'm ready to see this beautiful light streaming out of everything. Yeah. Okay. We can do it, and we will do it. That's it.